morning, tubers. I'm here at Ardingly Reservoir today. Day off. Here we go. So, Ardingly Reservoir is about 5 miles away from where I live. And I've done a little walk around here before. I'm just going to do a bit of a longer one. Goes for about 9 miles, but as I'm on a day off today, being Friday, also had my hair cut, look. It's a little bit too short today. Anyway, here we are. Going to continue to use the front camera, I think. There's someone on the boat out there. I'm going to use the front-facing camera. It's just a bit easier, generally. But, let's bring you in a little bit closer, eh? Got a brew kit with me today. Got a new pen knife. That's actually a lock knife, but I might show you that in a bit. Better if I go that angle, isn't it? Is that my best side, do you think? Anyway, being half term, school half term in West Sussex, I thought that I'd be really busy with mums and dads and children, but so far it actually is very quiet. Birds singing in the trees opposite. I'm actually quite warm now. That'll teach me for wearing a fleece. Got my rain gear in my bag just in case. And my brew kit. I was going to bring lunch, but I'm actually going to go home for lunch because it's only about 10 o'clock, half past 9, 10 o'clock. So I'm just going to go on a short walk because I've got a bit of a dodgy knee lately. And it's been playing me up, so I haven't been out for a while. Mate, you're fishing, look. I don't really catch anything. Now, I'll come back to you in a little bit. Okay, this trail I'm on is actually called the Kingfisher Trail. You can see it there. Not sure if that's backwards. Probably not, but there you go. He's singing away, isn't he? Let's go down here. This is a bird hide. I'll show you inside here as I'm walking past it. It'd be rude not to go and have a look at least. The reason I'm wearing sunglasses is I'm not trying to be like what's his name? Molly, Ronnie Woods. It's just it was actually a bit sunny when I got out of the car. Now I'm in woods, I look a bit stupid, but because I wear glasses, these are actually prescription, and I have got my other glasses with me, but they're actually in my bag. Look, bluebells. Quite good for a wild camp out here. Just be quiet now, just in case there's people in here. Just check first, hang on. No one in here. Apart from rubbish. Why do people leave rubbish? Look, there's a bin there. Why don't you just put the rubbish in the bin? Litter. It's one of my pet hates. Hate litter. There's no need for it. Take it with you. Put it in your pocket. I'd love to pick it all up, but I can't. I do pick some up. Cigarette ends in here, look. What's the matter with people? Anyway, enough about my ranting. I could rant on about litter all day. This is the little bird hide, which there's also, it could be a wasp hide, so I'm not going to be hanging around here too long. Probably a wasp's nest up in here somewhere. But there you go, you've got all the birds. If you're into bird watching, I'm not particularly. I like listening to them, I like looking at them occasionally. I'm not heavily into bird watching. That tells you all the different birds, etc. I thought this would be rammed with school kids. You could even do a wild camping here. But they do close it up. The gates to the car park are locked at 7. And there's a tied house to it, so I presume someone looks after the reservoir. So if you parked here overnight, I'm sure they'd probably kick you off. But yeah, I suppose you could hike in from the end of the road and sneak a wild camp somewhere. But oh, excuse me. Anyway, haircuts, right? Why are they so expensive for men? Literally. Had my haircut this morning in a different place than I normally have my haircut, although you wouldn't think it looks pretty similar. And I didn't even ask the price, I just went in because I dropped my daughter off. She had a theory, driving tested theory today. Dropped her off at 8 o'clock, went to get my haircut in Crawley, West Sussex, and drove past the barber's. It was empty, so I went in, didn't ask the price. My haircut's normally 14, 15 quid. In East Grinstead, where I live, and it literally took him like 20 minutes, not even that, 15 minutes. 12 quid. That's not bad earnings, is it? That's like 50 quid an hour. Still, I suppose we all strive to earn at least that. Being self-employed, you need to earn something, don't you? Well, I'm not going to take you on the whole of this walk. You'll be really bored, and then I'll start ranting about litter and other things. But when it gets a bit more picturesque, I'll bring you back in. See you in a bit. One thing I have got, look, see this here? That's a CRKT Minimalist Bowie. And I got this a while back. I always keep it on here, but I keep it on the carabiner. I can take it off if there's lots of people about or if I'm walking through a town or something. But literally that, great for whittling. It's tiny, it looks big when I zoom it in, but that is tiny, 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 really super light. Expensive, you can get it from Henny's. I think it was about £34, but it locks in, not going anywhere. And it's always there if you need it. In America, you can get them for about $20, but they're a specialist kind of knife, really. Very sharp, very good for whittling tiny pieces of wood or just mucking about with, really. But because it's, I think, technically illegal, it's well under 3 inches, but it is a fixed blade, so walking out with it probably is a bit dodgy, but it's not really too menacing to look at. There you go. Coppiced Woodland. I'm not going to read it all out for you. Yeah, see you in a bit. And the other side, this side, on the other carabiner, is one of those survival bracelets. eBay jobby. Paracord and tiny little fire strike and steel, which does actually work. Can light cotton wool with it. I'm not sure you'd light birch bark with it. I haven't tried yet. But I bought two or three of them. I wrecked one, just absolutely trouncing it to see how long it would last. You could survive on it for quite a few days, to be honest. But it obviously it's tiny, so basically, there's your strike, and there's the steel. But you have to break off the, oh, I can't get it in now, story of my life, can't get it in, to make it easy you have to break off the side bits to get it, but I suppose if you were going to survive you wouldn't worry about breaking a bit of plastic. Yeah, so I'm going to apologise about the wind because that's going to probably steam into my mic now, and then everyone's going to moan about it. Because do you know what? Another one of my pet hates, wind, as in not anal gas wind, but wind, atmospheric, going into people's mics. It winds me up. And some of my best YouTubers that I watch, I won't name them, go up mountains and all sorts, go up the Lake District and constantly, I just have to switch off. As much as I love them, I have to go. So do the same to me if it's blowing a gale in your ear. The thing I like about this trail so far, there's actually benches every sort of couple hundred yards, meters, whatever you want to say. And also, I do like a ploughed field. Check it out, Funk Soul brother. Nice fresh ploughed field, can't beat with it. But that's probably going back to my farming roots. Not that I am a farmer, but my grandparents were. And their parents were. Anglers only. Beautiful though. Can't believe there's no one here. Why would you not bring your children to walk around this park on a warm day? It's not raining. It's not a park, it's a reservoir. But I never did, in actual fact. Didn't even really know. I knew it was here, but I didn't really know there was a track around it. I used to go everywhere with my children, and still do. Even though they're not little kiddies anymore. How pretty that is through there, look. Bit of gorse. Peaceful. I'm now on the tip of where I can walk to this end. It does go across the road through the other side, but I started from way over here, right down the back there. So, a couple of miles already. Might be quite good up here for a wild camp. Yeah, those dogs in the background. All these beautiful bluebells. It's obviously a well-used path. So I'll just come and explore a little bit. I'm not going to go too deep because I'm not on an explore mission today. Just literally just on a walk. Hey tubers, I'm back. Walking back the way I came now. I did walk all the way right over to there. Hang on, where are we? Right over to there-ish. But you can't get back around the other side of the reservoir. You have to go up onto a road and stuff. And it's just like, I didn't come sort of park country to go and walk up a main road. Although I think it's country lane. But and also the miles is too long for my knee today. I think it's nine or 11 miles all the way around. Well, I've already done probably four, and I've got probably two more back, so that's six. That's ample for an old boy with a dodgy knee. Right, it's coffee time, guys. A bit like hammer time, but without the baggy trousers and cane. I'm just going to knock this up. Not sure if I can film it though, but I'll try in a minute. I'm going to spark it up with the fire still. It's a bit windy. So apologies. I don't think you're going to see into there. But there you go. Let's give it a go, shall we? There you go, it's done. It's a little bit windy. Right, I'll come back to you in a minute. First cook up of a brew in the field with my Trangia setup. with the IKEA candle holder. Lined it with foil in there, but left the hole this side. So hopefully that works.
We shall see.
Well, it didn't actually work initially, because I lined it with foil and there wasn't enough oxygen getting in there. But it's working all right now, I think. See in a minute. Here's the new knife. It's from Anglo Arms. Here's a lock knife. But it's quite good. It's about £11, I think. Not that I'm promoting their products.
It's getting there, look. Let's use my rucksack as a windbreak, which seemed to work.
I think Ducky thinks I've got some food for him. The only thing I've got is hot water, and he won't like that. Come on then. No bread, mate, sorry. Nothing. Lovely plumage. Shit, that was hot. Don't ever sweep your hand over your Trangia again. Especially as you can't see it.
Can you hear it?
I haven't got a glove though, so those handles are bloody hot.
Well, I reckon I'm going to take it off. There's pointless boiling it right up to death, but it has actually got a rolling ball.
Ball? Boil? That's boiling now, proper. Look. So I'm going to take it off now. I don't know how, but I'm going to do it with my hands or my scarf. Look at that, guys. Yeah. Empty. 300 mils is ample to fill up one of these. I think this is a Gillert, is it cut?
No, it's got a funny angle. Cut. It's like cut funny. I don't know why, if anyone can explain why.
It's really odd. But I thought they were like factory seconds or something, but I can see that. Maybe so you can drink out of a measure, I'm not so sure why. But yeah. Well, cheers guys. And I had a fantastic morning, but I've got losing my windbreak. That was quite a good idea, that. It's, the only problem is if it's too windy, it blows away obviously. But yeah, it's generally a good morning. Crowd's coming over now. But what's the time now? It's about 1:30. So I'm going to trundle off in a bit. So this will be the last of it. Thanks very much for watching. If you could subscribe, share, all that lovely stuff that you guys like to do. Thanks very much for watching. And I'll catch you in the next one. See you on the next one. You'll see me on the next one. I might do one on knives. I do actually like knives. Not that I'm some nutcase or something, but this one from Anglo Arms. It's not technically legal because it's a lock knife and it's over 3 inches, so it's illegal, basically. But as long as you don't wave it around in front of children and old grandmas, you'll be fine. Catch you later.